Good morning, everybody. Made it up here to Englers, and I backed it up on the wheels. We're getting ready to strap her down and put it to a little test here. See what kind of horsepower we're running. Been thrashing this morning already. Sir, what's your name?
Kyle.
Kyle
Rogers.
Kyle Rogers. So, running the show up here at Engler. You are right now.
He
got what? We got the right man on the job for us for sure. He said they were at Kokomo last night. They did pretty good up there. So I guess he done made the trip back home and ready to work on it for us. So that's a good thing.
Didn't even home longer.
I stopped at the house and took a shower and a little brief nap, and I just got in time to work, so.
Okay. All right. Fixing the strapper down now. You can check us out on Blurton's Racing Blog on YouTube. You can like, comment, and subscribe to us. Chasing Horsepower. Getting it set up on the wheels now to strap her down. It's Mr. Engler in there doing what he does best. Okay, we're getting the backup strap down now. And Kyle's kicking it. I'm gonna be coming in and out of this video a lot to try to keep it together, so. Maybe it'll turn out pretty good for everybody. Oh, did it really? I don't know what they're talking about in there, but probably pretty good stuff.
Take a brain surgeon to do that. So anyway, long story short, that's how my injector deal started. Mm-hmm. Because I got tired of, number one, I didn't like the side-to-side, the way they got that link going across there, and the motor heats up and cools down, it'll change the side-to-side. Mm-hmm. It's not as bad on 305 where the injector is all one piece, but it'll still vary. But that's why we put our cross-shaft linkage on it, all that stuff. But anyway, there's a lot of... But the biggest reason was flow. Why buy cylinder heads at least 40 CFM? So, I mean, if the cylinder head technology was going like this, and the injector technology was here. Mm-hmm. And it, like I said, on 305, it's not as big a deal because the head don't flow near as much. But on a 410, it's a big deal. But like on ours, where the port is, we've radiused the port.
That's why my 360.
Yeah, yeah. 305, we've done it. We've raised it 175,000 for a full over in there too, because it makes a lot more torque at 3,500, 4,500, like 30, about 30 foot pounds on 305.
Oil heated up on it right now, man, and I think that's what they're doing. Put some heat in the motor, and they're still thrashing around here real good. I mean, dirty white boys. Custom coatings. Give them a call at 901-870-3430 if y'all need some coating done. Yep. It's kind of cool up in this place, man. It's so clean. You can eat off the floor. Bob Hubbard out at RE, thank you for everything you did for us. fishing get real around here, y'all. Oh, I see. Get that post high.
It's all
the way. Oh, is it? They're trying to put that panel on there instead of keeping some of that heat out of the cockpit. All is going on right now. I'm just learning. It's the first time I've ever been up in here watching something like this go on. Very exciting already. They got the fans going to blow air kind of to the motor and the radiator, keeping it cool here. And I guess those fans back there, they pull out. They pull in the air out. So this, yeah, it's going to... Just seen the little TV screen up there. It's got the gets a little tax on it. What is that, Ernie? What is that right there?
That's the RPM and the wheel speed.
Okay. Then move the heater over here on the other side of the motor. Guess we're trying to heat that oil up. Maybe Kyle's getting up in there for the first time. Looks like he's fixing it real. Got the door brought down. We'll actually pull him away. All right, they said they're fixing to make some short runs, see what happens. All right.
Hey, we had Ray Saber to Ainsworth, because that way you don't get confused with my 360.
Okay. Well, what we're going to do, well, we can do that.
Don't be polluting the file.
Don't get that shit on this file.
Yeah, I won't get shit on
that. Keep her clean over on the other side. Ainsworth Ray Saber.
Okay. So what we'll do, is we'll cycle it here, just like we always do, get it up to 180. We'll pull that cardboard out there once it starts to be in one. Say Ainsworth, have a little head of what? What did he say he had?
A miss.
That was our first run on the dyno. Mr. Engler's going in there and trying to get this first little miss out of it. Gauge in it. I guess we're supposed to have a small drag on it or no drag at all. All right, you're going after it. I think you're going. Start it again. Mr. Angler's going on the second run here. Said the nozzles is a little fat. Heard it. The nozzles fat, he's changing the peel. What was that thing you do? Change it. What's he changing in there?
Change the peel.
Change the peel. Change the peel on it. hill in and gonna go back in here and hit it for the third try. Cranking it again. Going after it again out there. He's running off some stuff in here that I don't know nothing about, but so I can't help y'all with telling y'all what's exactly going on right now. But say, Keith, the nozzles a little bit for the cam.
Yeah.
So,
we'll put a stumble valve in it.
Put a stumble valve in it and,
put the fuel back like how we had it.
Put the fuel back, put the 70 back in it.
Mm.
That's the pill that they're talking about. It changes the, what the amount of fuel is dumping into the motor, whatever.